Hello, and welcome to a Tabletop Bellhop Cardboard Coat Check. I am Mo Tuzano, the Tabletop Bellhop, your cardboard concierge, working with you to make your game nights better. Now, today, what I'm hoping to do for you is let you know about the game, The Stuff of Legend, which I'm kind of holding up here. This is a board game based on the extremely popular graphic novel series about a boy being kidnapped by the Boogeyman, teleported to another world, where the players is a cooperative, semi-cooperative game, are playing his stuffed animals, trying to rescue him from the Boogeyman. And I kind of hid this a bit just to show off this. You can see the two worlds here. And when the toys go to the other side, they become human. Well, human's not the right word. They become alive, but they're not just, you know, teddy bears anymore. And we'll get to see some of this stuff once we crack the shrink. So this is from 3WS Games. That's Third World Studios, who I do have to thank for letting me take a review copy of this home from the Origins Game Fair. Now, this is the retail version of the game. This was Kickstarted. You could have backed it on Kickstarter. You would have got some deluxe components. Those are available separate. I don't have those. I just have the retail version of the game. And then I'm going to show you what you get in the box for The Stuff of Legend, the board game. All right, here you go. Cracking open my copy of The Stuff of Legend for the first time. Cooperative game. See, it says that. Of adventure and betrayal, 3 to 6 players. But this is a game more like Battlestar Galactica, the fantastic fantasy flight game. They replaced it with Unfathomable is the new printing. This is some of the stuffies will be working for the Boogeyman. Lot of different cards, a nice chunky box. We're going to start with this. So this is showing off your various different characters that you can play in this game. Now, each has a benefit and a flaw that can come up during the game. Quackers the duck, and on this side is what Quackers looks like as a toy. And on the other side, you see what Quackers looks like on the other side. And then we have Princess. I feel like we should start with the toy side. So let's start with Fillmore. The toy side, it's a hat. On this side, it's kind of creepy old dude. We have the general, who looks like a piece out of, say, Risk, which on the other side is a full knight, and so on. We're going to quickly go through these to kind of show off the various characters. Again, toy side, other side. Toy side, creepy enough, even more creepy. Max the Bear, which is the most depressed looking teddy bear I've ever seen, who turns into Max the Bear. It's a lot more characters than I actually thought in this. And Princess. So again, there's their special ability, there's their disadvantage, and then some little bonuses they get when making skill checks. Note, I have not played this game. I saw and was described to me at Origins in a vaguest of overviews, and it just sounded so cool. I had to have it. And the fact they likened it to Battlestar Galactica, one of my favorite games of all time, had me sold on it. And I got to say, this aesthetic is fantastic, which doesn't surprise me being based on a famous graphic novel. So these square cards are going to go out in the map, which we'll get to. So you have location cards. And the interesting one is there is more than one for each one. So what you find at the Ruined Zoo would not always be the same thing. So we have a bunch of location cards. And then the event cards that go on top. So when you discover the Ruined Zoo, you're going to flip this and get what it says. You know, it says, when revealed, add 2 troops to this space, then discard the card. And there are these for all the various different encounter spots on the map, which we'll get to in a minute. And then we have the Ruined Zoo things that can be there. This is actually one of like the named bad guys from the comic book series, O'Neill and so on. So artwork from the comic books. I don't know if it's direct or redrawn, but from what I understand, it seems like it's the same kind of striking look. Very clear iconography at the top. Prison inmates question the townsfolk. So there's various tasks you'll have to do. So this requires a 5 of that particular skill. Whereas if you were fighting the king, which is a cobra, which is a nice pun there, has 7 health and some special rules. So that's it for the location cards. Your action cards are next. All right, deck of action cards. It's huge. Look at it all. Tons of them. I'd say at least a 50-card deck, if not more. We haven't even gotten to the rules yet. That's interesting. So a bunch of these are just going to give abilities and symbols for your various things. Looks like you're going to want to really shuffle this before your first play, because all of the red ones, and then you have all the blue ones, and then you have all the green ones, which is the three different symbols in this game. Again, the artwork is rather striking. Looks like the iconography looks very clear to me. Looks impressive. Over here, we have the special card deck. Specials, loyalty cards, boogeyman cards, and some more actions. Wow. Okay, so is there another? More red. Oh, this is just a mix. Oh, these are the ones that are just provide resources. Some of them, I can't remember the turds, like Inky or whatever. If these come up, that's when the negative parts of your characters go off, is when these cards come up. And then Love of the Boy, because you are trying to save the boy, can be used as any resource. But then there's Power of the Dark, which is, again, Inky. I think it's Inky cards. Provides any two resources, but it's Inky. Again, this is not meant to be a teach. I may be off on that. So there's only a couple special cards here. I don't know what those are for. Boogeyman cards. This is the nasty thing happens. You're going to draw from the deck and something terrible happens because the boogeyman's acting. Loyalty cards are given out at the beginning of the game. And are you loyal to the boy or loyal to the boogeyman? And huge props for realizing... Ah, see, scout's friend, these two. These two are rough. These have no additional text, so it's nice and quick. You look, go, yep, I'm loyal to the boy. Yep, I'm loyal. I hate social deduction, hidden traitor games where you have a bunch to read and it's like, oh, why is he spending so much time staring at his card? He must be the traitor. Again, I haven't read the rules for this. Maybe it's not that bad. Maybe these are special, but there are two cards here that do have a lot more text on them than the rest. And finally, we get to the rules. All this was just like piled on top. Okay, here, to kind of go with the creepiness of this. Glad I didn't pick this one up for my girls when they were younger. There's a rather cool postcard style piece of artwork here that kind of sets the tone for the game. This is not happy your friends are going to come and save you. So rulebook, we're going to flip through this pretty quickly. It's 1944, so it's a period game. Love that layout. That is striking. That pops. That really pops. Looks like we are going to have some minis. You can see the board here, some of the other components. Obviously, we're going to get to some punch boards. This is the thing, because the whole goal of the game is to find the exit on the map before the boy is lost. Kind of shows the setup here, how to perform actions. Text a little small, some nice callouts. Full color is always nice. I know it seems silly to say that because most games are now. How the hero sheets work. Stained cards. I thought it was ink. Stained cards. How the boogeyman's coin works and so on. Not a simple game. This is not a quick to learn simple game. Nice QR code here to shop the store, because you can actually buy the graphic novels direct from 3WS. No summary on the back. I always appreciate a summary on the back. Hopefully there's some kind of summary cards. Looks like the player boards may have them. So this is the interesting initiative system in this game. Oh, that's a nice thick card. I appreciate that. More cool, creepy artwork. See, that just looks cool to me. And I noticed toys on both sides here, so that's interesting. So three characters are going to go, and when they go into exhausted, and then three different characters are going to go and go into exhausted, and the others are going to come out. So it's kind of interesting, because only three characters are going to get to go on every player turn. And there is your little rule summary of what you can do. So then we have just plastic. Oh, there it is. Look, it's all underneath. You know what? Let's do that next. Let's do the punch boards. Oh, that's a lot of cardboard. Yep. Okay, some of that's the board, though. Some of that. Actually, a large portion of that. Okay, that's all the board. Not a lot of punch boards, then. We'll get to that, to the board, in a second. So the punch boards, these are your standees for the various heroes, as well as two special tokens. There's an area of the map where you need to find a rope bridge to get across. This is a time tracker and so on. These are your portals you're trying to escape. Some of these are better components in the Kickstarter version. Various minion tokens and so on. We are just going to put that back. Now, the board is no way it's going to fit on my camera. This board is way bigger than I thought it was. So we're going to kind of fold this out and show off. Yeah, no way. I realize I'm going to get quiet while doing this because I'm away from the camera. Let's see if we can get the board up. Can we see all that? I'm peeking through the bit here, hoping you can see it. Massive board. Not the biggest I've ever seen, but significantly sized board to fit all those cards. Huge board, but it's got to fit all those cards, all those location cards. There's spots to put the various decks and everything on here, so I can kind of show that off. Spots to put the decks. There's your location cards. Those are your potential exits right there. Nice detailed. To be fair, that's going to take up a lot of room, but it's nice that it's going to be nice and spread up and not too busy. All right, what we're left with are miniatures, which for the mini fans, we do have to show these off. So this is just it's a token with the gun and the dog, which we're going to hope my camera will focus on. There we go. The dog and the rifle. The boy token. Okay, by hiding that, I thought this would work. There we go. See the boy with all of the animals surrounding him to protect him. It's toys, sorry, not all animals. Toys surrounding him. Great detail there on the face. Very cool looking piece. That's a chunky, very cool board game piece. And all right, in case you want some nightmares, we have the Boogeyman with heads and skulls at his base. Nice wicked evil grin here. Another very chonky, cool, almost like chess-like, actually, with these bases. They kind of feel like chess pieces. That's a nice touch. Now, a major part of the mechanics in this game is the coin toss. Now, if you did back to Kickstarter, you get a metal one, but you actually have a coin to toss here. And I got the boy, which would mean the boy starts sliding down towards being lost, which is bad. Or you could get the Boogeyman, which is draw a card from the Boogeyman deck. Plastic stands to hold up all those standees we saw earlier. And then a bunch of mooks. They all look the same? No, we have four different types of mooks, it looks like. Minions, mooks, whatever you want to call them. It's cool that these are minis. I didn't realize these were going to be minis. Evil looking clowns with knives. Creepy evil clowns. So there's a bag of those. There's five of those. I like that they're good size. They look like they're probably 32 millimeter figures. Should work good if you want to steal them to use in, say, your D&D games. Then we have, it looks like soldiers, army men type soldiers. Detail on these is okay. Definitely board game quality, not, you know, collector's miniature quality here. Miniatures are always nice. Check out episode something something of the Tabletop Bellhop Gaming Podcast, where we compare meeples and minis. All right, then we have what looks like a medieval knight with a dagger. And one more. Looks like a cowboy. Western theme. There we have the cowboy figure. The final minion mook type from Stuff of Legend. That is everything you get with the box insert. Looks great here for holding the miniatures, but I really hate the fact I'm now just like tossing these cards in here. There's no like card holder, nothing slotted to hold cards in here at all. Oh, and they don't even fit next to each other like that. Okay, I'm gonna put some cards there. Will these at least fit next to each other? Yes, those will fit at least. And then I'll stuff some guys here. All right, not the best box insert. It's not horrible, but those in there. Oh, there was a plastic thing. Here it is. Stop your board from getting scratched. That's a good bonus, actually. Where did I put the board? There you go. Everything you get in the box for the Stuff of Legend, the board game based on the graphic novel, The Stuff of Legend. Now, one thing that I think is worth pointing out for fans of the book, this only recreates. Sorry, that's so heavy. Look, boom. It's causing my camera to shake. It is a heavy box. There's a lot of cardboard in there, plus some cool minis. This is only based on book one of the graphic novel series. So Stuff of Legend, book one, The Dark. I don't know if there is going to be a book two. I know 3WS Games was talking about it. I don't know if it's in production. I haven't been able to follow up with them. So this is a semi-cooperative game, cooperative with hidden traitors. There is always at least one hidden traitor, but there may be multiple. So it's that type of game. If you don't like that kind of game, this is not going to be for you. I have been told this is the modern, the new Battlestar Galactica, which has me really excited because I love Battlestar Galactica from Fantasy Flight Games. I adore that. It's something about the role-playing nature of it. The whole things I don't normally like about social deduction didn't bother me in that game. So thank you for joining me. I will be talking about Stuff of Legend over on the blog at tabletopbellhop.com. And we'll be chatting about it on the Tabletop Bellhop Gaming Podcast, which you can find on your podcatcher of choice. If you did appreciate this video, it'd be awesome if you did the whole thumbs up, like, subscribe, and left a comment. All of those things make the mighty algorithm gods happy and lets more people see our videos. And come on, it was a cool video. There was cool stuff in here. Don't you want more people to see this? I don't know. I do. I want more people to see it. Thank you for joining me for this unboxing. Good day and game on.